break the backs. Loving to appear, loving to be praised. So this is a distinguishing character of the people of knowledge. Ibn Rajab says, from the signs of the people of knowledge, that knowledge leads the person who really has it to yahrab min ad-dunya. He runs from the dunya. Yahrab min ar-riyasa. He runs from trying to be a leader. Wa shuhra, trying to be famous. Wal madh, trying to be praised. He runs away from all of that. And he strives his utmost to avoid it. This is the sign of ilm al-nafi', the beneficial knowledge. And if it happens, listen to this, if it happens without his choice, if it happens and he wasn't trying to let nobody know what he was doing, but they praised him without his choice, they will have great fear, khawfun shadeed, great fear that their ending would be bad, that this was a plotting from Allah tabarak ta'ala, wa ishrajan from Allah for sins that they had committed in the past. That this is a way of Allah ta'ala pulling them to their punishment. Like Imam Ahmad thought. When Imam Ahmad, who had been beaten for saying that the Quran was the words of Allah tabarak ta'ala, Imam Ahmad who had been tortured. One man said, I hit Imam Ahmad with such a whooping and beating that if I had to beat an elephant would have fallen out. Broke his arms and everything. Stayed patient, sabiran upon this aqidah. An imam in that time, till they say now that Islam was saved twice. Abu Bakr Sadiq fi ayyam ridda. Abu Bakr Sadiq radiallahu anhu, when the people apostated after the death of Prophet Islam. Well, Imam Ahmad fi ayyam al-mihna. And the Imam Ahmad when Ma'amun and others were putting them to trial for not believing their innovative belief. Killing others and torturing them. He came out of the prison. And it looked like the whole dunya was there to greet him. The whole dunya was wanting to carry him on their shoulders. The whole dunya was saying, Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahmad Sunnah. Someone said, what do you think about that, Imam Ahmad? He said, I feel that it may be istidraj. I feel that it may be due to my sins. Allah Ta'ala, due to me disobeying Allah, that Allah Ta'ala is pulling me to a bad destination or a bad ending. This is the sign of the scholars. Also, he doesn't want money. Money. There's a distinguishing point between the money that is given, for instance, to Aimat al-Haram, or to Imams of Harams, or brothers who are giving dawah, whatever. You give them money to free them up to be able to give that dawah. That's called a ratiba, it's okay. But to make your dawah just for money, and your mawaqif, your stance based upon money, this is not the way of the salaf. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ said, or not why, but we can say, this is in turn dealing with the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ of Ka'b bin Iyad radiallahu anhu, which says, for every ummah there is a fitna. And the fitna of my ummah is money. For every ummah there is a fitna. Shaykh Muqbil, rahimahullah, used to mention this hadith often. When many left him, many of his students who were upon istiqamah left him for the various jama'iyat and societies that offered them money and opened the doors for them to all types of lives of luxury. He would say, the Prophet ﷺ said, verily for every ummah there is a fitna, and the fitna of my ummah is the money. Naam, wealth is a fitna. How many people have went astray? Some of the best students of knowledge have went astray and joined the groups of bid'iyah and the hizbis based on the fact that they gave them some money. Also, we're not going to get to a lot of what I wanted. Labas, inshallah. No, I don't want to go over. I prefer to stay within the time. I like this new thing of being on time. It's incredible. It's a good bid'ah. In the sense that this is what we were supposed to do before, right?
and now we're reviving it. That's what Umar meant, right? Ilm al-Nafi' that Ibn Rajab. I think, to be honest, we should go ahead. I should go ahead and just mention this few lines, and then we can get some money from you brothers, inshallah. we'll talk about that, inshallah. There are scholars in our time, walillahi alhamd. There are still inheritors of the Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam existing amongst us. Allah ta'ala has not left us hamalan without guidance. He has not left us without those who have a chain going all the way back to Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But it's upon us to take them, respect them, love them and benefit them. Like from them, like the likes of Shaykh Abdullah ibn Baz. وشيخ ابن تيمين وشيخ الألباني وشيخ محمد أمان الجامي وشيخ حمار انصاري وشيخ عبد الرزاق عفيفي وشيخ مقبل الحالي الوادعي and others of them who have passed away. All of those are dead, رحمهم الله. وشيخ تويجري رحمه الله. All of those are dead. These are those who everyone is sure about their knowledge. The Muslims trust them and they take their knowledge from them. And they benefit from them. And then those who are alive amongst us. Shaykh Allama Ahmed ibn Yahya al-Najmi. Even though I didn't hear, Dawood said something about him being sick. Huh? You mentioned his sickness? That's what I understood. Jayyid. Hafidhullah. Wa Shaykh al-Fawzan. Wa Shaykh Zayd al-Madkhali. Wa Shaykh Abdul Aziz al-Shaykh. Wa Shaykh Abdul Muhsin al-Abbar. Wa Shaykh Ghadiyan. Wa Shaykh Sali al-Uhaydan. وشيخ ربيع بن هادي المدخلي وشيخ صالح الصحيمي وشيخ عبيد الجابري and many many others who are upon their way. These are the a'imma a'lam, the well-known scholars that we take our deen from, and that we believe that those who oppose them or talk bad about them, then it's a sign of his deviancy. This is signs of his deviancy. And they are from Ahlul Ilm, who Allah said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَحْلِ الذِّكْرِ Ask the people of dhikr, إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And they used to examine people and people's mawqif and position regarding those who were the carriers of the sunnah. They weren't hizbis because or intershakhsiyah, because that is like what Ibn Taymiyyah said, مَنْ نَسَبَ شَخْصًا He who places a man because of what he calls to from himself. And loves and hates based upon that man. That's something different. They're not calling to themselves. We love them because they're of what they carry of the sunnah. If Rabi' did not carry the sunnah, we wouldn't have a love for him. If Rabi'